Voila! My brand new storymobile! Hello, Huckle. Hello, Loli. What do you think of my shiny new storymobile? Pretty nifty, huh? I built it to hold stories about Busytown.
Do you have any apple stories?
Can we see the books, Mr. Fixit?
Of course.
Hey, it's empty.
Oh, no. I must have forgotten the stories.
I am a born writer. Maybe I can write the stories for you. In fact, I... Whoa, whoa! Come back here, Hat.
Looks like Mr. Frumble can't help us right now.
But who will write all the stories for the Storymobile?
I'm sure if we drive around Busytown, we'll find people to write some stories. That way, the Storymobile will be full of stories in no time.
That's a great idea.
Hop aboard, kid!
Wow! Isn't this neat?
All it needs is some good stories.
Don't worry. We'll find some great ones in Busytown. We can even write some ourselves with the story writer. The shelves will be filled in no time.
I can't wait to start reading. I'm a regular bookworm, you know. We can go to the farm and ask Farmer Soybean to write us one.
Or we could go on a camping trip with Hilda. She'll write us a story.
Then there's the beach, the market, and the school.
We're sure to get stories if we go all those places. Then afterwards, we can read them by selecting a book from the shelf.
And we can always stay right here and write our own stories.
There's so much to do. Let's go. We need to drive around and collect stories.
Let's hit the road and start gathering up those stories. Let's go to Farmer Soybean's farm.
What a great day!
For the last time, Hat, come here.
Soybean, we're collecting stories to put in the Storymobile.
Would you write one for us, please?
I'd like to write some stories, but I have a lot of work to do around the farm. I have to put the hay into the barn, pick the apples in the orchard, and do the farm chores. But if you help me around the farm, I'd be pleased and proud to write stories for the Storymobile.
We'd be delighted to help.
You've got a deal.
Duck. Hose. Rooster. Chicken. Well,
wagon. If you want to help with the farm chores, you could start in the field.
Let's help Farmer Soybean and put the hay into the barn.
I love apples. Let's go to the orchard and help pick them.
Cow.
Each apple on this tree has a letter on it. If we find the ones that match...
K. K.
You got it!
C.
That's right!
O.
Hooray for you! Good work! Let's pick another basket of apples.
Three left.
H.
Nice job!
D.
Way to go!
R.
That's great!
U.
Excellent! Let's pick another basket of apples.
Only two left.
D.
Terrific! You got it!
L.
That's right! Hooray for you! Let's pick another basket of apples.
Only one more to go.
L.
Good work!
B.
Nice job!
E.
Way to go! That's great! We did it! We filled all the baskets with apples!
Maybe Farmer Soybean is finished with a story. We can go see.
Or we can pick more apples. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Good work, Huckle and Loli. You finished and so have I. I just put my first story in the storymobile.
Thanks, Farmer Soybean.
I can't wait to read it.
Windmill. Hey. Farmer. Tractor. Weather vane.
Here are three pictures of work that has to be done on the farm. Our job is to figure out which one happens first, second, and last.
Click on a picture, then click on the spot in the story where you think it goes.
Then click OK.
A hen sits on the eggs. A hen sits on the eggs. The eggs hatch. The chicks run.
Excellent! Let's do another.
Now there are five to go.
Do you want to play?
Fill up the pan. Fill up the pan with sliced apples. Bake the pie. Time to eat. Yum!
Terrific! Let's do another.
Four more.
The fence needs painting. The job is almost done. The fence looks beautiful.
Hooray for you! Let's do another.
Three left.
bucket in the well, pull it up slowly, carry the water home.
That's great! Let's do another.
Only two left.
Rake up all the leaves. Put them in the bags. The bags are full.
Way to go! Let's do another.
Only one more to go.
We need to wash the clothes. The wind helps them dry. Time to put them away.
You got it! Hooray for us! We put all the pictures in the right order.
Farmer Soybean may need our help with something else. We could go see, or...
There's plenty more to do around here. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Great job, Huckle and Loli. You finished and so have I. My second story is in the storymobile.
Thanks a lot.
I hope it's about apples.
We have to figure out if these two things rhyme.
If the two words rhyme, click yes. If they do not rhyme, click no.
Then we can put all the hay into the barn and help Farmer Soybean.
Cow. Cat.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Pail. Box.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Pig. Wig.
You're right. They do rhyme.
Only five more bales of hay left.
Do these words rhyme?
Fly. Pie.
You're right. They do rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
House. Horse.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Dog. Corn.
You're right. They do not rhyme.
Only four more bales of hay left.
Do these words rhyme?
Truck. Truck. Duck.
You're right. They do rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Bee. Bee.
Do these words rhyme?
Hat. Duck.
You're right. They do not rhyme.
Only three more bales of hay left.
Do these words rhyme?
Chick. Cat.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Box. Hat.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Dog. Log.
You're right. They do rhyme.
Only two more bales of hay left.
Do these words rhyme?
Cat. Bell.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Horse. Bell.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Hen. Cat.
You're right. They do not rhyme.
Only one more bale of hay left.
Do these words rhyme?
Sheep. Sheep. Jeep.
You're right. They do rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Pig. Frog.
You're right. They do not rhyme. Do these words rhyme?
Wow. Cow. Wow.
You're right. They do rhyme.
We did it! We put all the hay into the barn.
We can see if Farmer Soybean is finished with a story now.
Or, there's always more hay to put into the barn.
Do these work?
Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Good work, Huckle and Lowly. You finished and so have I. I just put the third story in the storymobile.
Thanks, Farmer Soybean.
That wasn't very hard at all.
Do you think we can still find some more stories?
Right this way.
Our busy farm. We have such a busy farm. Each day there's much to do. The morning starts with rooster's call. Cock-a-doodle-doo. Busy. On my tractor, I plow the field. Turnip plants rows of seeds. The seeds grow into vegetables, what everybody needs. Vegetables. I cut the hay and bundle the bales, then haul them to the barn. Up into the loft they go, where they stay dry and warm. Dry. In the orchard, I spend some time picking apples from the trees. Turnip takes care of the beehives, where honey is made by bees. Honey. We load up the truck with our produce and drive it to the store. We sell the fruits and vegetables, then go home and grow more. Home. We load up the truck with our produce and drive it to
planting corn. Farmer Soybean is up and dressed early in the morn. He sips a cup of tea and says, "It's time to plant some corn." First, he plows the field in nice neat rows like these. Then, with his planter, he sows a lot of seeds. Soybean brings a sprinkler. It sprinkles to and fro. This gives the seeds some water. Water helps them grow. With Farmer Soybean's care and the sun's warm rays, the small plants start to grow in just a few days. Soybean's corn grows tall. It's really growing fast. Silk tassels peek out from the leaves. The ears appear at last. When the corn silk starts to brown and the ears are ripe and thick, Soybean's hard at work again. The corn must all be picked. Ears. Soybean drives the corn picker from sun up until dark, until the ears of corn he picks fill up his cart. Grocer Dog sells the corn at his market down the street. People come from miles around to buy some corn to eat. Grocer Dog. Soybean looks at his cornfield. He says, "It's time to eat." He picks some corn and cooks it. My corn is sweet. Sweet. The missing eggs. Mr. Farmer Pig wakes up early. Mrs. Farmer Pig is already up. Mr. Farmer Pig stretches and yawns. He goes to the hen house to get some eggs. Stretches. Mr. Farmer Pig looks inside the hen house. There are no eggs to be found. Mr. Farmer Pig looks outside the hen house. There are no eggs there either. "Oh no," says Mr. Farmer Pig. "The eggs are missing." Oh no. Mr. Farmer Pig walks to the barn. He looks in the front of the barn, and he looks in the back. But there are no eggs. Mr. Farmer Pig searches the cornfield. He looks to the left. He looks to the right. No eggs. Cornfield. Are the eggs in the orchard? Wonders Mr. Farmer Pig. He looks up. He looks down. But all he sees are apples. Poor Mr. Farmer Pig. Mr. Farmer Pig scratches his head. "I give up," he says. "There are no eggs on my farm today." Mr. Farmer Pig walks to the house. Orchard. Good smells are coming from Mrs. Farmer Pig's kitchen. "Good morning," says Mrs. Farmer Pig. "Here are your eggs." Lucky Mr. Farmer Pig. He finds the missing eggs after all. Cooked just the way he likes them. Lucky.
A camping we will go.
What a great day!
Just look at that hat go!
Well, hello, Huckle. Hello, Hello, Loli. What are you doing here in the woods? We're looking for interesting stories for the Storymobile, Hilda.
Would you please write us a story?
I'd love to, but I've got lots of things to do around here. Like what? Catch fish for dinner. Go on a scavenger hunt. And find the missing marshmallows to roast on the campfire. If we do all those things for you, would you write some stories for the Storymobile? Sure I would.
Right on. We can go on a scavenger hunt, but first, we need the list.
Why don't we try to catch some fish at the lake? I think I put the marshmallows near the campfire.
Hamburger. Sleeping bag. Backpack. Let's look around the campsite for Hilda's missing marshmallows.
Good thing we have a flashlight.
If we find the things that start with the letter on the backpack, we'll find those marshmallows.
Let's put them in the backpack when we find them. That should clean things up.
Bird.
Hooray for you!
Bird. Begins with bell.
Terrific!
Bell. Begins with B. Butter.
Nice job!
Butter. Begins with B.
We found a marshmallow!
Now there are five to go.
Look, Loli. More things to put away. We're sure to find a marshmallow here.
Pickles.
You got it!
Pickles. Begins with P. Peas.
That's right!
Peas. Begins with P. Paints. Paints.
Hooray for you!
Paints. Begins with P.
We found a marshmallow!
Four more.
Look, Loli. More things to put away. We're sure to find a marshmallow here.
Bat.
Good work.
Bat. Begins with B. Book.
Nice job.
Book. Begins with B. Box.
Way to go!
Box. Begins with B.
We found a marshmallow!
Three left.
Look, Loli. More things to put away. We're sure to find a marshmallow here.
Cat.
That's great!
Cat. Begins with C. Coat.
Excellent!
Coat. Begins with C. Cap.
Terrific!
Cap. Begins with C.
We found a marshmallow!
Only two left.
Look, Loli. More things to put away. We're sure to find a marshmallow here.
Pie.
Hooray for you!
Peas.
That's great!
Pen.
Way to go!
Pen. Begins with P.
We found a marshmallow!
Only one more to go.
Look, Loli.
Hen.
You got it!
Hen. Begins with H. Hamburger.
Hooray for you!
Hose.
Terrific!
Hose. Begins with H.
We finally did it! We found all the missing marshmallows!
They'll be great to eat! Now let's go see if Hilda's done with the story.
Are you sure you want to stop playing this game? Oh, Huckle, Loli, thanks for your help. I just finished my first story. It's waiting for you in the storymobile. Thanks, Hilda. I can't wait to read it.
Wow, a real campfire story.
Hilda wants us to find all the things on the list.
It must be around here somewhere. Find and click it.
Squirrel.
Nice job!
Wig.
You got it!
Net.
That's right!
Nest.
Hooray for you! Let's do another scavenger hunt list.
Three left.
Goose.
Good work.
Bird.
Nice job.
Cooler.
Way to go.
Map.
That's great.
Only two left.
Pineapple.
Excellent!
Cow.
Terrific!
Ink.
Hooray for you!
Milk.
That's great! Let's do another scavenger hunt list.
Only one more to go.
Bag.
Way to go!
Corn.
You got it!
Bread.
Hooray for you!
Jam.
Terrific! All right! We found everything!
Hilda should be finished with a story now. We could check.
Or we could stay and look for even more things. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Oh, Huckle, Loli, thanks for your help. I just finished my second story. I put it in the storymobile.
Thanks, Hilda. Another one.
I love stories.
Cooler. Picnic basket. Camera. Tent. Nest. Tea. Tent. Flashlight. Tree. Canoe.
Each fish in this lake has a letter on it. If we catch the ones that match,
we can fill the buckets for Hilda.
I.
You got it!
You.
That's right!
J.
Hooray for you!
H.
Good work! Let's fill another bucket with fish.
Three left.
C.
Nice job.
M.
Way to go.
F.
That's great.
A.
Excellent. Let's fill another bucket with fish.
Only two left.
Q.
Terrific!
P.
You got it!
E.
That's right!
W.
Hooray for you! Let's fill another bucket with fish.
Only one more to go.
P.
Good work.
Q.
Nice job.
W.
Way to go.
E.
That's great. Oh, boy. We filled all the buckets with fish.
Do you think Hilda is done with a story now?
We can go see, or we can just keep fishing. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game? Thanks, Hilda.
Another campfire story.
Rowboat. Flower.
Do you think we can still find some more stories?
Right this way.
Pig will and pig won't.
Pig Will and Pig Won't are going camping with Hilda. Mother Pig waves goodbye. Have fun, she says. I will, says Pig Will. I won't, says Pig Won't. Pig Will. At the campground, Hilda asks, who will help me pitch this tent? I will, says Pig Will. I won't, says Pig Won't. Hilda and Pig Will pitch the tent. Campground. Next, Hilda asks, who will help me fetch some water? I will, says Pig Will. I won't, says Pig Won't. Hilda and Pig Will fetch the water. Fetch. Now who is going to help me build a campfire, asks Hilda. I will, says Pig Will. Can you guess what Pig Won't says? Hilda and Pig Will build a campfire. Campfire. Then Hilda roasts some marshmallows over the campfire. Who's going to help me eat these marshmallows, she asks. I will, cries Pig Will. I will, cries Pig Won't. Will you, Pig Won't? Asks Hilda. Says Pig Won't. Maybe I should have said I will earlier when you needed me to help. I'm sorry. That's okay, says Hilda. Just please don't say I won't anymore. I won't, says Pig Won't. Okay.
Camping out.
Huckle and Loli are going camping tonight. They decide to pitch a tent in Huckle's backyard. Father Cat is raking leaves in the yard. Can I give you boys a hand? He asks. Father Cat helps the boys put up the tent. Then he shows them how to build a campfire. Wow, says Huckle. You sure know a lot about camping, Dad. Father Cat says goodnight. Don't forget to put out the fire. Good night. Huckle and Loli toast marshmallows over the campfire. Just then, they see a strange light. Huckle and Loli jump up. What's that? They ask. Hi, Huckle. Hi, Loli, someone calls. It's Kenny with his flashlight. Kenny sits down with the boys. He starts to tell a story. It's about a ghost with a big claw. Kenny. I have to go now, Kenny says. Good night. Huckle and Loli put out the fire and get into bed. You're not scared, are you? Huckle asks Loli. No, not me, answers Loli. Suddenly, they hear a noise. Plink, plink. What was that? Asks Huckle. Maybe it's a ghost, says Loli. Huckle peeks outside. It's just the water from the pump. Ghost. Then they hear squeak, squeak! What was that? Asks Huckle. Maybe it's a ghost, says Loli. Huckle peeks outside again. It's not a ghost. It's just the clothesline pulling. Suddenly, Loli cries, look! On the tent is a shadow of a big claw. It's the ghost, shouts Loli. Run, yells Huckle. Huckle and Loli run back to the house as fast as they can. Squeak. Squeak. In the morning, Huckle and Loli wake up in Huckle's room. They tiptoe out of the house and back into the tent. Father Cat comes to wake them. You boys were brave to stay out all night, he says. The first time I went camping, I was so scared, says Father Cat. All night long, I saw the shadow of a big claw on the tent. In the morning, it turned out to be just the shadow of a rake. Boy, was I surprised! Tiptoe.
The Three Fishermen.
Huckle is so excited. Today is his first fishing trip ever. Come on, Dad. Come on, Loli, yells Huckle. Mother Cat waves goodbye. Good luck, boys, she says. The three fishermen get into the boat. Father Cat starts the motor. Away they go. This is going to be the best fishing trip ever, says Father Cat. Fisherman. In just a little while, Father Cat stops the boat. Throw out the anchor, he tells Loli. Oops, the anchor isn't the only thing that goes into the water. Loli goes in, too. Are you all right? Huckle asks. Yes, says Loli, as he climbs back into the boat. Come on, says Father Cat. Let's catch some fish. Fish. All of a sudden, something pulls on Father Cat's line. I think it's a big one, he says. Father Cat has something on his line, all right, but it isn't a fish. It's an old bike. Father Cat casts his line again. Again, there is a pull on his line. It's not a fish, though. It's a tire. Bike. The three fishermen try again. Do they catch a fish? No. This time they catch an old mattress. We're catching everything but fish, says Huckle. You're right, Huckle, says Father Cat. We might as well go home. The three fishermen pull up to the dock. But when Father Cat steps out of the boat, splash! He falls into the water. Help! Yells Father Cat. Something's got me! Splash! Huckle and Loli pull Father Cat out of the water. Look at that big fish, Huckle points. It's got Dad by the tail. At last, Father Cat gets the fish into the boat. I guess that makes up for all the fish we didn't catch, he says. It sure does, says Huckle. You know what, Dad? This has been the best fishing trip ever. Catch.
Oh boy, the beach!
What a great day!
What's a well-dressed pig to do without a hat?
Hello, Sergeant Murphy. I'll bet you can write some great stories for the Busytown Storymobile.
That's if you're not too busy.
Oh, but I am much too busy. I have to direct traffic in the parking lot, clean up the beach, and fly kites.
What if we helped you?
Then could you write some stories?
Well then, yes, you bet I could.
Let's help Sergeant Murphy clean up the beach.
We can fly kites over in the grass.
Go to the parking lot if you want to help me park the car. Fish. Starfish. Ball. Umbrella. Hat. Pelican. Ice cream cone.
Boy, is the beach messy. Find and click all the things that have the same ending sound as the picture on the trash can. Then click on the trash can.
And the beach will look great when we finish. Remember, we're listening for the ending sound, like hat and bat. They both end with t.
Hen.
Way to go!
Hen. N. Hen. Ends with N. Sun.
That's great!
Sun. N. Sun. Ends with N. Bun.
Excellent!
Bun. N. Bun. Ends with N.
That can is full.
Now there are five to go.
Carrots. Horse.
Terrific!
Horse. Horse. Ends with paints.
Hooray for you!
Paints. Paints. Ends with goose.
That's great!
Goose. Goose. Ends with
that can is full.
Four more.
Egg. Wig.
Way to go.
Wig. G. Wig. Ends with G. Flag.
You got it.
Flag. G. Flag. Ends with G. Jug.
Hooray for you!
Jug. G. Jug. Ends with G. Rug.
Terrific!
Rug. G. rug. Ends with g.
That can is full.
Three left.
Sun. Pen.
Nice job.
Pen. N. Pen. Ends with n. Bun.
You got it.
Bun. N. Bun. Ends with n. Van.
That's right.
Van. N. Van. Ends with n.
That can is full.
Only two left.
Clock. Duck.
Hooray for you!
Duck. K. Duck. Ends with K. Rock.
Good work!
Rock. K. Rock. Ends with K. Book.
Nice job!
Book. K. Book. Ends with K.
That can is full.
Only one more to go.
Ham. Jam.
Way to go!
Jam. M. Jam. Ends with M. Clam.
That's great!
Clam. M. Clam. Ends with M. Broom.
Excellent!
Broom. M. Broom. Ends with M.
Wow! The beach looks great! We cleaned it all up!
I wonder if Sergeant Murphy has finished writing a story. We could go find him.
Or we can keep picking things up off the beach. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Huckle, Loli, you've been a great help. And I just finished a story. I put it in the storymobile.
Thanks, Sergeant Murphy.
It'll be a good one to read on the beach.
Let's help park the cars in the right spaces. Just find and click the car that matches the sign.
Then click the sign to put it in the parking place.
Terrific! Hooray for you! That's great! Way to go!
You got it! Hooray for you! We sure know our cars. We help park all of them.
That was fun. Now let's see if Sergeant Murphy has finished writing a story.
Or we can park some more cars. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game? Thanks a lot, Sergeant Murphy.
Another story. Shovel. S. Shovel. Lifeguard. Crab.
Look at those kites. If we match the picture on one kite with the word on another, I'll bet they'll go way up in the sky.
Read each word, then find the picture that goes with it and make those kites fly high.
Peas. Terrific! Hey. Nice job. Duck. You got it. Hat. That's right. Let's fly some more kites.
Tail.
Hooray for you!
Lamb.
Good work!
Mask.
Nice job!
Apples.
Way to go! Fly some more kites!
Towel.
That's great!
Cake.
Excellent!
Nest.
Terrific!
Dog.
Hooray for you! Fly some more kites!
Cup.
That's great!
Pig.
Way to go!
Corn.
You got it!
Fish.
Hooray for you! We did it, Loli! We matched up all of the kites!
All high flyers, too! Now let's go see if Sergeant Murphy has finished writing a story.
Or we can fly some more kites. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game? Thanks, Sergeant Murphy!
I can't wait to read this one!
Lighthouse! Surfer! Clam! Snorkel. Sailboat. Fish.
Do you think we can still find some more stories?
Right this way.
The treasure hunt.
Huckle and Loli are at the beach. What do you want to do, Huckle? Loli asks. Let's look for treasure, suggests Huckle. Okay, says Loli. But where? Huckle looks around the beach. He sees something on the sand. Look, Loli, says Huckle. X marks the spot. Loli. Huckle and Loli start to dig. Suddenly, something goes clank. It sounds like silver, says Huckle. Huckle digs up the treasure, but it's only an old tin can. Huckle and Loli dig some more. Suddenly, something goes clunk. It sounds like gold, says Huckle. Huckle digs it up, but it isn't gold. It's only an old wheel. Clank! Huckle and Loli get tired of digging. They decide to walk along the beach and look for treasure. Huckle and Loli find lots of things on the beach. An umbrella, a pail, and an old shirt. But they don't find any treasure. They pick up cans, bottles, and newspapers too. But still no treasure. Digging. Huckle and Loli stop at Bruno's snack stand. They show Bruno what they found on the beach. Maybe you didn't find any treasure, Bruno says, but I never saw the beach look so clean. Bruno's snack stand. Bruno gives an ice cream cone to Huckle and Loli. That's for cleaning up the beach, he says. You boys did a great job. Wow! Thanks, Bruno, they say. I guess we found treasure today after all. Thanks.
Fun in the sun.
The sun is high. The temperature's hot. The waves lap at the sand. Hilda's going to the beach with her beach bag in her hand. Sun. First, Hilda takes out sunscreen and spreads it everywhere. Then comes the chair and umbrella and a hat to cover her hair. Sunscreen. Out comes a bucket and shovel to build sandcastles today. But first, she drinks lots of water. Her body keeps cool that way. Cool. What else can Hilda have in that bag? Ah, sunglasses and a book. Everything a hippo could want, Hilda surely took. Hippo. Because she packed her bag so well, she's really got it made. Sometimes the best kind of fun in the sun is really in the shade. Shade. Catch your hat, Mr. Frumble! It is a windy day at the beach. Mr. Frumble builds a sandcastle by the shore. Whoops! The wind blows Mr. Frumble's hat away. Catch your hat, Mr. Frumble! Calls Sally Cat as it blows by. Mr. Frumble. Sally Cat. Mr. Frumble chases his hat down the beach. The hat blows out onto the water. Catch your hat, Mr. Frumble! Calls Huckle, swimming by. Mr. Frumble chases his hat into the water. The hat blows onto a boat. Catch your hat, Mr. Frumble! Yells Captain Willie as it sails by. Huckle, Willy, Mr. Frumble chases his hat onto the boat, but now the hat blows on top of the lighthouse. Catch your hat, Mr. Frumble, calls the lighthouse keeper. Mr. Frumble chases his hat to the top of the lighthouse. He nearly gets it. All of a sudden, a puff of wind blows it back down the beach. Poor Mr. Frumble. Lighthouse. Mr. Frumble's hat blows right through Bruno's snack stand. Look out, everyone! Yells Bruno. Suddenly, the wind stops blowing. Mr. Frumble's hat lands on Hilda's beach chair. Uh-oh, everyone calls. Quick, catch your hat, Mr. Frumble. Quick. Bruno's snack stand.
It's the supermarket.
a great day!
I wish that hat didn't love to fly so much.
Hi, Bruno! We're collecting stories from different people in Busytown.
To go into the brand new storymobile. Sounds like a great idea, but I have lots of work to keep me busy here in the market. I have to collect the bananas. I have to bag the groceries. And I have to restock the shelves. So if you want me to write stories, you need to help me around here. Okay.
We'll do it.
To restock the shelves, please go into the storeroom.
Let's go to the checkout lane and help bag the groceries.
Let's go get bananas from the produce section. Pumpkin. Cans. Shopping cart.
Wants us to help him fill up the bags with groceries.
If these two things begin with the same sound, click yes. If they don't, click no.
Pie. Bananas.
Right, they do not start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Ham. Hot dog.
Right! They do start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Pickles. Apples.
Right! They do not start with the same sound.
Only five more bags to fill.
Do these have the same sound?
Peaches. Pears.
Right! They do start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Butter. Bananas.
Right! They do start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Peaches. Pineapple.
Right! They do start with the same sound.
Only four more bags to fill.
Do these have the same sound?
Beans.
Potatoes.
Right! They do not start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Strawberries. Pears.
Right! They do not start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Corn. Fish.
Right! They do not start with the same sound.
Only three more bags to fill.
Do these have the same sound?
Beans.
Cucumbers.
Right! They do not start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Peanut butter. Popcorn.
Right! They do start with the same sound. have the same sound?
Milk. Marshmallows.
Right! They do start with the same sound.
Only two more bags to fill.
Do these have the same sound?
Lemons. Lamb chop.
Right! They do start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Ham. Hot dog.
Right! They do start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Oranges. Cucumbers.
Right! They do not start with the same sound.
Only one more bag to fill.
Do these have the same sound?
Butter. Bananas.
Right! They do start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Corn. Peas.
Right! They do not start with the same sound. Do these have the same sound?
Pineapple. Pears.
Right! They do start with the same sound.
We filled up the whole shopping cart. We're good grocery packers, Loli.
We sure are. Now we can go see if Bruno has written a story.
Or we can bag more groceries.
Do these have the same sound?
Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Great work, Huckle and Loli. I'm all done with my first story. It's waiting for you in the storymobile. Thanks for all your help.
Oh, boy! Thank you, Bruno.
From the grocery shelf to the bookshelf.
Our job is to collect 10 bananas. Find and click the item in the produce shelf that begins with the same sound as the item on the shopping cart.
Then click the shopping cart. Loli begins with L.
Like lettuce, Loli.
W.
That's great. We got a banana.
Now we need 9 more.
Milk. M.
Way to go.
Melon. Begins with M.
We got a banana.
8 more to go.
Cow. C.
You got it.
Corn. Begins with C.
We got a banana.
7 more now.
Cap. C.
Hooray for you!
Cucumbers. Begins with C.
We got a banana.
Only 6 more to go.
Rake. R.
Terrific!
Radishes. Begins with R.
We got a banana.
Now there are 5 to go.
Pie. P.
Nice job.
Pineapple. Begins with P.
We got a banana.
Four more.
Goat. G.
You got it.
Grapes. Begins with G.
We got a banana.
Three left.
Anchor. A.
That's right.
Apples. Begins with A.
We got a banana.
Only two left.
Well. W.
Hooray for you.
Watermelon. Begins with W.
We got a banana.
Only one more to go.
Ant. A.
Good work.
Apples. Begins with A.
Well, we did it, Huckle. We got all the bananas.
Oh, no. Looks like we're not finished yet.
Or we can see if Bruno was finished writing a story.
Map.
Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Perfect timing, Huckle and Loli. I just put another story in the storymobile. Thanks for all your help.
Thank you, Bruno.
I can't wait to read this one. Butcher. Eggs. Milk. Broom. Baker. Oven. Cake.
Bruno needs help restocking these shelves.
Let's do it, but how?
Click on the spot where each new grocery item belongs.
Baked goods.
Way to go!
Milk. Dairy.
That's great!
Strawberries. Fruits.
Excellent!
Let's shelve another cart of groceries.
Fruits. Hamburger. Meat and fish.
Hooray for you!
Ice cream.
Dairy.
That's great!
Let's shelve another cart of groceries.
Vegetables.
Way to go!
Lamb chop. Meat and fish.
You got it!
Cake.
Baked goods.
Hooray for you!
Let's shelve another cart of groceries.
Baked goods.
Terrific!
Apples. Fruits.
Nice job!
Radishes. Vegetables.
You got it!
Let's shelve another cart of groceries.
Meat and fish.
That's right!
Carrots. Vegetables.
Hooray for you!
Grapes. Fruits.
Good work!
Let's shelve another cart of groceries.
Dairy.
Nice job!
Potatoes. Vegetables. Chicken. Meat and fish.
That's great! We did it, Loli!
What a great team! We restocked the whole store!
Now we can see if Bruno is ready with a story.
Or we can stock more shelves.
Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Huckle and Loli, I'm all done with my third story. I put it with the others in the storymobile. Thanks so much for your help.
Oh, boy. Thank you, Bruno.
That wasn't so hard.
Do you think we can still find some more stories?
Right this way.
The best mistake ever. Mother Cat needs some things at the store. I can go to the store for you, says Huckle. All right, Huckle, says Mother Cat. Let me make you a shopping list. Mother Cat gives Huckle the list. These are the things I want you to buy, she says. Apples, butter, cream, potatoes. Don't worry, Mom, says Huckle. I'll get everything you need. Mother Cat. When Huckle gets to the store, he reaches into his pocket for the list. Oh no! It is gone! I hope I can remember everything Mom needs, says Huckle. Huckle starts to shop. First, he sees some apples. Did Mom want apples or apple pie? Huckle asks himself. Huckle picks apple pie. Everything. Next, Huckle finds the butter. Yes, he says, I think Mom wanted butter. But I think she wanted peanut butter. Huckle reaches for peanut butter. Huckle sees a sack of potatoes in the next aisle. Did Mom have potatoes on her list? He wonders. Then Huckle sees a bag of potato chips. I think these would be better, he says. Peanut butter. What does Huckle see next? He sees cream. What does Huckle buy? Ice cream. Huckle pays for all of the food. Then he goes home and proudly shows Mother Cat all the things he bought. But Huckle, says Mother Cat, these are not the things I wanted. This is party food. Party. Just then, the doorbell rings. It's Auntie Olympia and Lily. Mother Cat is surprised. She forgot that she had invited them over. Mother Cat looks at all the party food on the table. Huckle, she says, it looks like you got just what we needed after all. Your mistake was the best mistake ever. Auntie Olympia.
Bananas for Bananas.
Bananas wakes up early in the morning. Boy, I'm hungry, he says. He looks for some bananas to eat. There are no bananas. What, he says? No bananas? Bananas looks for some money to buy bananas, but he can't find any. What, he says? No money? How will I get bananas? Bananas thinks hard. I know, he says at last. I'll get a job. Bananas. Bananas goes to Scotty's gas station. He asks Scotty for a job. Okay, Bananas, says Scotty. You can paint this school bus. Bananas paints the school bus. Then he shows it to Scotty. Do you like it? Asks Bananas. Oh, no, cries Scotty. That's not the way to paint a school bus. Scotty tells Bananas to find another job. Oh, no! Bananas still has no money, and he still doesn't have any bananas. So Bananas asks Mr. Stitches for a job. Okay, Bananas, says Mr. Stitches. You can trim these hedges for me. Bananas trims the hedges for Mr. Stitches. Do you like them? He asks. Oh, no, cries Mr. Stitches. Mr. Stitches tells Bananas to find another job. Mr. Stitches. Bananas still doesn't have any money. He still doesn't have any bananas. And he is still hungry. Just then, Huckle and Loli come by. Hi, Bananas, they say. What's wrong? I just lost two jobs, says Bananas. I'll never get money to buy bananas. You're in luck, say Huckle and Loli. There's a ship in Busy Bay, and it's full of bananas.
Busy Bay.
Whoa, says Bananas. I'm on my way. Bananas hurries over to Busy Bay. He asks Captain Anteater for a job. Okay, Bananas, says Captain Anteater. You can help in the kitchen.
Bananas helps out in the kitchen. This time, he does a great job. He still has no money, but now he doesn't need any. He has all the bananas he wants.
Wow!
The Talking Bread.
Humperdinck opens up the Busytown bakery. Let's bake some bread, he says to Able Baker Charlie. Can I help too, Daddy? Asks Sophie. Sure, answers Humperdinck. First, Humperdinck and Sophie knead the dough. Squish, squash, squish, squash. Next, they shake the dough into loaves. Humperdinck. Humperdinck puts the loaves into the oven to bake. When they are done, he sets them out to cool. Mmm, says Sophie, they smell good. Just then, they hear a voice. Mama! Who said that? Asks Humperdinck. I think the bread said it, cried Sophie. Mama! Mama! Everyone looks. It said it again, yells Charlie. That bread must be haunted. Humperdinck calls Sergeant Murphy, who comes right away. Huckle and Loli come too. Sergeant Murphy. Sergeant Murphy picks up the loaf of bread. Mama, the bread says. Sergeant Murphy jumps. I'll get to the bottom of this, says Loli. He nibbles his way into the bread. Again the bread says, Mama! I know what it is, says Loli. Break the bread open, please. Jumps. Humperdinck breaks open the bread. Inside is Sophie's talking doll. It fell into the dough and was baked inside the bread. After that, everyone sits down to eat the bread. Except for Loli, of course. He had already eaten plenty. Eaten.
Busytown Schoolhouse, right ahead.
What a great day!
For the last time, Hat, come here.
Hello, Miss Honey. We were wondering if you could write us some stories.
For the new Storymobile.
Stories for a Storymobile? That sounds like a wonderful idea. But unfortunately, I have too much to do right now. I have to put the books away, fix the alphabet strip, and do a spelling lesson.
If we helped you, could you write some stories?
I'd be delighted.
That's great!
I use the blocks to help with the spelling lesson.
The alphabet strip is over the blackboard.
The books are kept on the bookshelf.
Magnet. Paint. Puppet theater.
Let's put the ones that do not belong into that box.
Kite.
That's great!
Kite doesn't belong on the H shelf. Basket.
Way to go!
Basket doesn't belong on the L shelf. Stapler.
You got it!
Stapler doesn't belong on the B shelf. Carrots.
Hooray for you!
Carrots doesn't belong on the J shelf. Bird.
Terrific!
Bird doesn't belong on the R shelf. Popcorn.
Nice job!
Popcorn doesn't belong on the W shelf.
Yes! Now we can go see if Miss Honey has finished the story.
Or we can stay and put away more books. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Hello, Huckle and Lowly. I finished a story. I put it in the storymobile for you, and if you keep helping, I will keep writing.
Thanks a lot, Miss Honey.
I can't wait to read this one.
Calendar. Window.
Uh-oh! Some of the pictures have fallen down.
Let's try to put each one back where it belongs.
We have to match each picture with the alphabet letter it starts with.
Ruler. R.
Hooray for you!
Ruler starts with R. Egg. E.
Good work!
Egg starts with E. Xylophone. X.
Nice job!
Xylophone starts with X. Anchor. A.
Way to go!
Anchor starts with A. Ink. I.
That's great!
Ink starts with I.
This is fun!
Umbrella. U.
Excellent!
Umbrella starts with U. Fire. F.
Terrific!
Fire starts with F. Bird. B.
Hooray for you!
Bird starts with B. Zebra. Z.
That's great!
Zebra starts with Z. Mouse. M.
Way to go!
Mouse starts with M.
Let's keep going!
Goose. G.
You got it!
Goose starts with G. Wagon. W.
Hooray for you!
Wagon starts with W. Can.
Terrific!
Can starts with C. Lamb chop. L.
Nice job!
Lamb chop starts with L. Olives. O.
You got it!
Olives starts with O.
Let's finish the whole alphabet.
Quilt.
That's right!
Quilt starts with Q. Duck. D.
Hooray for you!
Duck starts with D. Turtle. T.
Good work!
Turtle starts with T. Yogurt. Y.
Nice job!
Yogurt starts with Y. Ketchup. K.
Way to go!
Ketchup starts with K.
Let's finish the whole alphabet.
Sunglasses. S.
That's great!
Sunglasses starts with S. Paints. P.
Excellent!
Paints starts with P. Net. N.
Terrific!
Net starts with N. Hey. H.
Hooray for you!
Hey starts with H. Van. V.
That's great!
Van starts with V. Jam. J.
Way to go!
Jam starts with J.
The alphabet strip is all done. We sure know our letters, Loli.
Should we see if Miss Honey is ready with a story?
We could, or we could try to match some more letters and pictures. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
Huckle and Loli, thanks for your help. I wrote another story. It's waiting for you in the storymobile.
Thanks, Miss Honey.
This is fun!
Chalkboard. Book. Flower. Piano. Clock. Globe. Bell. Door. Computer.
Oh, boy! Let's spell some words.
All of these words have a missing letter. Let's fill in the blanks.
O. Pot. P. O. T.
You got it!
E. Hen. H. E. N.
Hooray for you!
Hat. H. A. T.
Terrific! Let's spell some more words.
Now there are five to go.
Do you want to play?
J. Jam. J. A. M.
Nice job!
B. Box. B. O. X.
You got it!
C. Cow. C. O. W.
That's right! Let's spell some more words.
Four more.
P. Cup. C. U. P.
Hooray for you!
Bat. B-A-T.
Good work!
N-B-U-N.
Nice job! Let's spell some more words.
Three left.
C. Can. C. A. N.
Way to go!
M. Map. M. A. P.
That's great!
B. Bag. B. A. G.
Excellent! Let's spell some more words.
Only two left.
E. Pen. P. E. N.
Terrific!
I. Pie. P. I. E.
Hooray for you!
A. Bag. B. A. G.
That's great! Let's spell some more words.
Only one more to go.
T. Net. N. E. T.
Wait a...
Cap. C. A. P.
You got it!
G. Jug. J. U. G.
Hooray for you! We did it, Loli!
We sure did! We spelled all the words correctly! Do you think Miss Honey has had time to write a story?
We can go check, or we can spell some more words. Are you sure you want to stop playing this game?
I've finished, Huckle and Loli. Thanks for all your help. I just put my third story in the storymobile.
Another one, Miss Honey?
We have a lot of stories now.
Wow! Loli! The storymobile is filled!
What should we read first?
We need to drive around and collect stories.
Let's hit the road and start gathering up those stories.
The best birthday party ever. Huckle's favorite day, his birthday, is only 1 week away. He decides to plan a party. Huckle makes a list of things to do. 1. Buy balloons. 2. Buy party favors. 3. Make a big cake. 4. Invite friends to come. Birthday. This is going to be the best birthday party ever, Huckle says. On Monday, Willie Rabbit telephones Huckle. I'm sorry, Huckle, he says. I can't come to your party. I have to go to my grandmother's house. Best. On Tuesday, Billy Dog telephones Huckle. "I'm sorry, Huckle," he says. "I can't come to your party. I have to go to the doctor." On Wednesday, PJ Pig telephones Huckle. "I'm sorry, Huckle," he says. "I can't come to your party. I have to go to the dentist." Doctor. On Thursday, Loli telephones Huckle. "Oh, Loli," Huckle cries, "no one can come to my party. This is going to be the worst birthday party ever." "Don't be sad," Loli says. "You can come to my house for your birthday. We'll have fun. Just don't forget to bring the cake." Sad. On Friday, Huckle walks to Loli's house. He goes inside. "Surprise!" everyone shouts. Huckle is very surprised. All his friends are here. "Happy birthday, Huckle," everyone says. "Do you like your party?" "It's the best birthday party ever," says Huckle. Surprise. Miss Honey's ABCs. A. Abby Rabbit ate all the apples. Ah, Abby. B. Bananas Gorilla has no bananas today. Boo-hoo. C. Sally Cat counts the clouds. 1, 2, 3. D. Billy Dog dares to dance. Get down, Billy. E. Danny Elephant eats 8 eggs. Yes, exactly 8. Boo-hoo. F. Farmer Soybean grows flowers in his field. Sunflowers. G. Mr. Gronkle goes to the grocery store. Go, Mr. Gronkle, go. H. Hilda Hippo sits on Mr. Frumble's hat. Uh-oh, a flat hat. I. Irving Goat ice skates in the winter. Isn't it nice on the ice? J. Janitor Joe cleans up in a jiffy. Just wonderful. Go, Mr. Grunkle, go. K. Kathy Kitten keeps her kites in the air. Way to go, kiddo! L. Spotty Leopard makes a left turn. So long, Spotty! M. Mr. Fixit made the storymobile. Marvelous invention. N. Nurse Nora reads the newspaper. What's new, Nora? O. Oliver Octopus only eats olives. Oh, Oliver! P. Pig Will puts pumpkins in a pile. Pig Won't pouts. Way to go, kiddo! Q. Quentin Owl always asks questions. He is quite curious. R. Rudolph von Flugel roars by in his jet. He's really fast. S. Sergeant Murphy says, "No speeding, bananas." Stop. T. Turnip tends the beehives. Terrific honey. Stop. U. Ursula Pig unfurls her umbrella. Stay dry, Ursula. V. Victor Bear visits his grandma. Very nice. W. Loli Worm watches the huge waves. Wow! X. Xavier plays his xylophone. Excellent! Y. Yvonne Yak collects yellow yarn. Yikes! Z. Zachary Zebra has zippers everywhere. The end. The end.
The best field trip ever.
Miss Honey has to leave school for a few days. A substitute teacher is coming to take her place. His name is Mr. Tuff. Here he comes now, says Loli. Good morning, class, says Mr. Tuff. Let's get to work. We have to get ready for our field trip. Mr. Tuff even sounds tough, says Huckle. Mr. Tuff. Mr. Tuff gives the class books to read. Huckle reads about fossils. Kenny reads all about dinosaurs. Hilda reads about rocks. Read all you can, says Mr. Tuff. You have to be prepared. Mr. Tuff gives the class exercises to do. In the gym, Huckle does sit-ups. Hilda does push-ups. And the whole class plays tug-of-war. Get as strong as you can, says Mr. Tuff. You have to be prepared. Dinosaurs. On the day of the field trip, Mr. Tuff gives everyone shovels. Then they get on the bus. When the bus stops, Mr. Tuff shouts, "Okay, class, start digging." Everyone groans. More hard work. Suddenly, Hilda's shovel hits a rock. Clang! That's not a rock, says Mr. Tuff. It's a fossil of a dinosaur egg.
You're out!
Shovel.
You're out!
Wow, says Huckle. Let's see what else we can find. Soon, they find a dinosaur bone and some dinosaur teeth. All of a sudden, Mr. Tuff slips and falls. He slides down the mountain. We have to save him, yells Huckle. Huckle throws a rope to Mr. Tuff. The kids pretend it's tug of war. Heave ho! At last they pull him up. Dinosaur bone. Thanks, class, says Mr. Tuff. That was hard work. It's a good thing we were prepared, everyone says. We thought this trip would be too much work, says Huckle. But it was worth it. This has been the best field trip ever.
Here.
Best.
Here.
You can write your own story here. Type the words you want. There are two ways to choose pictures for your story. Click the arrows or use the Busytown buttons to get a picture about that place. Don't forget to print your story by clicking the printer button. Use the silly arrow button to write a silly story. Here is a silly story you can help write. Use the arrows to choose another story. Click the words and pictures to fill in the blanks. Click the read button to hear your story read aloud. Don't forget to print your story by clicking the printer button. Log. Sunglasses. Sandals. Sunglasses. Globe. Blocks. Bird. Zipper. Farmer Soybean is a good log. He likes to grow sunglasses and sandals. One day he saw that his sunglasses were ripe, so he picked them and put them in his globe. Farmer Soybean took the blocks to the bird. Then he went back to the zipper. Sink. Paints. Net. hen. Jeep. One day, Farmer Turnip woke up and got out of sink. Something was happening to her paints. Turnip went out to the net to see what was wrong. The pen had turned into a jeep. Jug. Juice. Frog. Fox. Cookies. Cooler. Mop. Plate. Pineapple. Once there was a farmer who had a jug. Every day he took his frog to the box. One day the cooler was missing. The farmer got into his mop and drove to the plate, but the pineapple was never seen again. Are you sure you want to leave?
Are you sure? Are you sure you want to quit?